Hello guys, welcome back. So guys, here in this session, now we are going to explain your SAP project and its types. So in previous session I already told that in this session I'll explain SAP project and its types. So guys, now how many types of projects are there in SAP? Let's suppose you have done this. Let's suppose you have learned this SAP FICO module and you become a consultant. You got the placements. The moment you are going to join, let's suppose, so the very first day itself, or like whenever you got, let's suppose already your recruitment has been done for a particular project. So your HR will be like, they'll be greeting, hi, welcome on board. And now you are going to be part of so and so project, right? It could be like, if you talk about types of project, we are having four types of projects: implementations, rollout, upgrade, and support. So if you, if this is like, okay, you're going to be part of implementations project, you're going to be part of rollout project, you're going to be part of upgrade or support project, so at least you should have some overall idea, like, okay, what is this implementation project, what is this rollout project, what is upgrade project or support project. Right, you should have some overall idea, like what kind of activities are going to happen in this, in this kind of projects and all. So anyway, so here theoretically, I'll just give some overall, idea about this SAP project and whatever these types of projects are there that I'm going to explain in this session. So guys, now if you talk about project, look at here, project is nothing but a task or assignment. Right, in terms of SAP, it is divided into four parts. The moment you are going to join a particular organizations, you'll be part of a particular project. You'll be part of particular project means, let's suppose, I'll explain, don't worry, in details. So you're going to be part of a particular project. In that, you're going to assign certain roles and responsibility. Okay, so perfect understanding you guys will be having, because as I said, like multiple seasons are yet to come. So slowly you guys will be having perfect understanding about each and everything, and most of your questions, I think automatically it is going to be answered, because as I said, like, not possible to explain each and everything in a single session. So anyway, here in this session I'll explain SAP project and its types. So implementations, rollout, upgrade and support project, these are the projects are there, guys. Now we'll do one thing, one by one we are going to discuss. So if you talk about implementation project, what is this implementation project, guys? So here I'll quote an example. Earlier in the first session, what I have done, guys, I have quoted example of Tata Motor. So now I'm going to continue with that itself, Tata Motor itself. Now here, so say for example, this Tata Motor. Tata Motor is using, let's suppose, an ERP called Tally. And now, since it is like their business has grown and setup and everything has grown, so now like management of Tata Motor required various different kind of reports, which is not possible to fulfill such kind of requirements with the help of Tally. Why? Because it is a very small ERP. So very limited number of activities are going to be performed, and based on that, very limited number of reports are going to be fetched from Tally. So now here, Tata Motor management, they decided to go for a bigger platform. So bigger platform means, of course, like they have decided, they have like searched out multiple things and all, and based on that, and based on their research and all, they have decided to go for SAP. Okay, so now SAP is going to be installed in Tata Motor. Okay, so now what is happening here in Tata Motor, this SAP installation is going to happen, that is first time it is getting installed, right? So first time installation of SAP, installation doesn't mean that, okay, once the SAP is installed, everything is perfect and they will start using. After installations, even multiple configurations also need to be done, guys. Those things we are going to discuss one by one in upcoming sessions. Several sessions are there, so these all things you guys are going to see one by one. So here what is happening, installation of SAP in Tata Motor, and this is first time installations. Before that, what is happening, before that Tata Motor was using Tally ERP. So SAP, what SAP is going to do, guys, SAP is going to replace this Tally ERP. In the sense, SAP is going to be installed, automatically Tally is going to be replaced by SAP. So look at here, if you talk about implementation project, the definition is quite simple. First time or fresh installations of SAP in any organization is called implementation project, right? Further, entire implementations is going to be segregated in five phases. That is going to be discussed. I'll try to record a separate video on this, guys, because multiple phases are there, and in details, again, that is also going to take lots of time, because every phases are going to be explained in details. Okay, so a separate video will be recorded on this one, and that is also going to be published as soon as possible. Soon I'll try to publish that one. Okay, like in implementation project, how many phases are there, what kind of activities are happening, right? So lots of things are there to explain in that, lots of things are there to discuss in that. So as I told, that a separate video will be recorded. Multiple videos need to be recorded for that, and that is also going to be published as soon as possible. So now, right now here, we are talking about implementation project, right? So implementation project means what? Look at here, first time installation of SAP in any organization is called implementation project, right? This is a perfect example. In Tata Motor, the installation of SAP is going to happen first time itself, because before that, Tally was there. Now, there is one more thing. If you talk about implementation, then the question is, what kind of implementation it is? Whether it is like, or else, like, if you talk about implementation project, that is also going to be segregated. It is going to be divided into two parts. That is called greenfield implementation and brownfield implementations. I'll tell you, most of you might be beginner, or I think you'll be having some little bit idea. You might have already watched some tutorial and all. So still I treat those people as also as a beginner itself, because most of the cases they know some configuration part and all, but they don't know the logic. And if you don't know the logic, then whatever things you have learned, there is no use of those things. Why? Because you know how to do, but you don't know why to do. So if you don't know why to do, in that case, whatever you have learned, there is no much use. Because if you go for interview, if interviewer started asking questions, they are going to ask scenario based questions. They'll give you a scenario and then you have to answer those questions, guys. So scenario based question you can answer only if you have perfect, like if you're going to understand the question first. And you can understand the question only if you're having perfect understanding about that particular topic, right? So anyway, now here, so we were talking about like implementation project. So it is going to be segregated, divided into two parts, that is greenfield implementation, brownfield implementations, right? So now, what is called greenfield implementation, what is called brownfield implementations, what is the difference? I'll tell you guys, for this there won't be, you won't be finding any tutorial, you won't be finding any videos, but it's very 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 easy. Okay, now the current example which I told you, right, the current example which I told you, that is like we are having Tally, right? And it is going to be replaced by SAP. Okay, so this is called, brownfield implementations. Okay, now this is the example of brownfield implementations. Okay, I'll just type in shortcut. Okay, brownfield implementations. This is called brownfield implementation. Okay, so brownfield implementation means what, guys? SAP is what? This is called like SAP is called like new ERP. The implementation of new ERP is SAP is the new ERP, right? And this is called old ERP, which is already like which is running in the Tata Motor, right? So old ERP means what, guys? In SAP language, it is called legacy system. Keep in your mind, okay? So this is how you guys are going to be unique, because now everybody will say like, okay, old system, old ERP or something. So whatever the existing ERP is there, right? SAP is going to replace what? It is going to replace Tally, right? This is the, and this is SAP. So this is new ERP, but this is called legacy system. Legacy system is the existing, or you can say old ERP. Now, so this is the example of brownfield implementation. Brownfield implementation means what, guys? Brownfield implementation means existence of legacy system. It means SAP is going to replace a legacy system, right? Now, if you talk about greenfield implementations, then greenfield implementations, what is happening, guys? In greenfield implementations, we won't be having legacy system. Okay, so now here, brownfield implementation means existence of legacy system, but greenfield implementation means if you talk about like greenfield implementations, right? So in greenfield implementation, let's suppose here, or else I'll specify here. So in greenfield implementations, what is happening, guys? If you talk about legacy system, so no legacy system in greenfield implementations, no legacy system. I'll just keep this one here. Okay, I've just written in shortcut itself. So this is brownfield implementations and this is greenfield implementations. Greenfield implementation means no legacy system. Brownfield means there is legacy system. So what is the differences between greenfield implementation and brownfield implementation, guys? That is, in greenfield implementations there is no legacy system, but in brownfield implementations legacy system will be there. I'll tell you one more thing later in upcoming session. Again, I think of course it is going to come into picture later. Now, if you're having, like, if you're the part of brownfield implementations, then more activities are going to be performed. More activity in the sense, say for example, in Tally, like let's suppose Tally is going to be replaced by SAP. So what will happen here? Now here, Tata Motors says that in Tally they are having multiple datas, right? So those data they need in SAP also. Why? Because let's suppose if there is a requirement that what is the percentage growth in terms of profit, in terms of expenses, in terms of revenue. So if somebody is going to calculate percentage growth, then growth percentage growth can be calculated only if you are going to compare one data with other. Like let's suppose whatever data is there in the current financial year, data is going to be compared with the previous financial year data, right? Previous financial year is going to be compared with again the previous to previous financial year. So this is how, if you compare, then only you can, like, we are going to get the percentage, you know, growth in terms of profit, loss, revenue, expenses, whatever it is. So now here, let's suppose, so in this current financial year itself, let's suppose this year itself, we are going to install this SAP into Tata Motor. So what about, like, Tally is going to be used for like 20 years back it was installed, in the sense that Tata Motor started using 20 years back. From past 20 years they are using Tally. So it means 20 years data are already there into Tally. So what client will say that now we need those data into SAP also? So in that case, what is happening, guys? In that case, they have to perform one activity. What activity, guys? That is called data migration activity. Okay, so now here, what is happening? Look at here. This is called data migration activity. Data migration activity. Okay. This is also called cutover activity. Okay, in details, as I told you, once I you know, record a video for project phases, in that it is going to be covered, that I'll explain in details. Okay, now, so now what is happening here? Data migration activity is going to happen. So this data migration activity is going to happen in which types of implementation, guys? Always in brownfield implementations, right? Not in greenfield implementations. In greenfield, there is no legacy system. So if there is no legacy system, no data migration activity, because let's suppose a totally new setup, the company is going to be set up, let's suppose totally new setup is going to happen. Plant construction is still under progress. Their corporate office is also like being built up somewhere. So at the same time, let's suppose after 1 year, if this plant construction is completed, in the sense manufacturing unit is completed, their corporate building offices is also completed, employee hiring is also done, what next? In order to run that particular organizations, they need some ERP also. Software is required, right? So what will happen? Installation of software doesn't mean that within few days it is going to be done, right? It also takes time because after installations, multiple configurations are going to be done based on the client requirement, right? So these entire configurations we are going to do one by one, multiple things we are going to see in the upcoming sessions, not worry. So now here, what is happening, guys? So in greenfield implementations, everything is new. So if everything is new, it means SAP is also newly going to be installed, implemented, right? So in greenfield implementations, legacy, what to say, data migration activity will not be there. But in brownfield implementations, data migration activity will be there. So now if somebody asks, okay, that what kind of, like, how many types of implementation projects are there? Two types of implementation project is there, greenfield and brownfield implementations. Brownfield means existence of legacy system. Greenfield means no existence of legacy system. From SAP itself, they are going to be started, right? And if brownfield implementation is there, in that case, of course, data migration activity will be there. But in greenfield, no data migration activity. Why? Because there is no existence of legacy system. Hope it is very clear to understand, guys, because I'm giving a very simple example to make you people understand. Now, so here, this is all about the implementation project. I already explained, like, first time installation of SAP in any organization is called implementation project, right? Now we'll discuss about the next one, that is called rollout project. Now, what do you mean by rollout project? What happens in this? So here in rollout project, what is happening? Now, look at here, I have taken example of Tata Group. Now, Tata Motor is the part of, in the sense, subsidiary of Tata Group, right? So Tata Group is having multiple other subsidiary. If you talk about the installation of SAP, in the sense implementation of SAP, at group level, let's suppose Tata Group has decided that, okay, we have to go for every subsidiaries are using different ERP, small ERP. So if they want to get a consolidated report means, like, what is the total revenue from Tata Motor? What is the total revenue from Tata Steel? What is the total revenue from Tata Chemical and all? So since every subsidiaries are using different ERP, different software, there is no integration at all. Tata Motor is using, let's suppose, Tally. Tata Steel is using QuickBook. Tata Chemical is using Oracle or any other ERP. So now what will happen if they want to see the consolidated report? It means manually this report need to be prepared. It's going to take lots of time. There might be a chances of error also, right? So here what is happening? Tata Group has decided that now we have to go for a bigger platform and SAP is the best. So in that case, they thought, why not to start from one subsidiary? We'll see. We'll do this installation in at least start from Tata Motor itself. We'll see the performance for 6 months or 1 year, and after that, if performance is satisfactory, then the same is going to be installed even in other subsidiaries also. So let's suppose here in Tata Motor, what is happening, guys? SAP is installed. It means SAP implemented. They have watched the performance for 6 months, 1 year, whatever it is. And if they are satisfied, then what is happening, guys? Now the same is going to be installed even in Tata Steel also, in Tata Chemical also, in other subsidiaries also, right? So now for under Tata Group, this is the first subsidiary where we have installed this SAP. So this is called implementations, right? And after that, the same installation is going to happen in other subsidiary also one by one. Those are also a kind of project, guys, because for Tata Steel also separate, the whichever IT company is going to install this SAP, in the sense simply SAP installation is going to happen. So who is going to do this? IT companies, right? So whichever IT company is going to take this project, they'll charge some amount for that, right? So now here, Tata Motor is a separate project that is called first time installation of SAP. So this is called implementation project. But Tata Steel is first time for Tata Steel, but under Tata Group, this is the second time installation is going to happen, right? So this is called a rollout project. In the sense, first time we have installed this SAP into Tata Motor, that is implementation project. After that, whichever other subsidiaries are there, wherever like we are going to install this SAP, whether it is Tata Steel, Tata Chemical, Tata Hotel Group, or Tata XYZ, whatever the company, sorry, subsidiaries are there. Subsidiaries are called company code in SAP language, guys, that we are going to see later in the sense upcoming sessions, don't worry. So whichever other subsidiaries are there, wherever we are going to install this SAP, these all installations will be called a rollout project. In the sense, every activities are a kind of project. So these all installations will be called a rollout project. For Tata Motor, SAP installation is like implementation project, but for Tata Steel, Tata Chemical, Tata Hotel Group, or remaining whichever the other subsidiaries are there, that is called like rollout project. So here, if you talk about the simplest definition here, guys, the definition is if a group company already implemented SAP for one subsidiary and want to set up the same for different subsidiary is called rollout. For first subsidiary, it is implementations, and remaining whichever subsidiaries are there, wherever we are going to install this SAP second time onwards, that is called rollout project. Okay, so this is what the difference. I'll tell you guys practically some differences will be there. Some differences means if in let's suppose implementation project. Okay, so in implementation project, let's suppose we are having like this is implementation project. So in implementation project, we have to perform 100% of activity from first to last. Each and every configurations need to be done. But in rollout project, what is happening, guys? 60 to 70% only is going to be activities are going to be performed. Remaining, what is happening, guys? Remaining already, since we have already done certain configurations during implementation project, those configurations are going to be done. Okay, practically, I think if we go further, like if you see the further session and all, then you'll be having perfect understanding, because here theoretically only I'm explaining. But again, like practically, if you are going to proceed further, then you guys will be having understanding, and I'll let you know like which activities are going to be performed and which activities are not going to be performed, right? So it's not like you need to mug up like which activities are going to be performed. And see, if you are able to understand, right, then easily you guys will be, you'll be able to understand, okay, what activities are not going to be, performed during rollout. Okay, so right now here is not possible to explain practically, but that you guys will come to know. So here what we are talking about, rollout project, right? So rollout project means if a group company already implemented SAP for one subsidiary and want to set up the same for a different subsidiary is called a rollout project. Now, what next, guys? So the next one is upgrade project, right? So upgrade project, I don't think like it's difficult to understand. The name itself is telling you the definition, guys. Upgrade project means what? Shifting from one version of SAP to other. In upgrade project, what is happening? We always shift from lower version to higher version. Whichever ERPs are there in the market, guys, even let's suppose take example of your smartphone. We are using multiple apps. Facebook is there, YouTube is there, WhatsApp is there, right? Hike Messenger is there, multiple other apps are there. So every after 15 days or 20 days or 30 days, you receive some notifications to update your app. Updation means what, guys? It's a kind of upgradations, because whichever the technical team is there, they'll keep on, adding some additional functionality, right? Say for example, Facebook is there right now, chatting functions are there, but they have developed even video call also. Just assume that they have developed this video calling also functionality. So what will happen now? You'll be getting, let's suppose you got one notifications that now update your Facebook. So updation message means what, guys? It means you are going to avail the new functionality only if you upgrade your Facebook, right? Likewise, WhatsApp or whatever it is. So here in SAP also, what is happening, guys? In SAP also, they'll keep on adding new features. They'll keep on adding what is a new functionality. So of course, like client must have to go for upgradations, and it is a continuous process, because every time some new additions will happen. So every after might be 5 years or 6 years or 10 years, it depends upon client, they must have to go for upgradations. So this is also a kind of activity, guys, and this is also going to be treated as a project. This one also takes time, right? Now, so upgrade project means what? Shifting from one version of SAP to other version. And if in upgrade project, always we shift from lower version to higher version, right? Now we are having the last one that is called support project. So what is happening, guys, in support project? Post implementations, all SAP related maintenance or error activities comes under support project. See, for example, we have installed this SAP. In the sense, implementation is done. Implementation is done in Tata Motor, or is like rollout we have done in Tata Steel, right? Rollout is also is done in Tata Steel. Now, so after implementations or after rollout, if we have implemented this SAP in Tata Motor, then what will happen, guys? Do you think that they will proceed further without our help? No. Implementation is done. Now Tata Motor is quite happy. They started processing their entire transaction in SAP. But what will happen if they face any error in future? Who is going to resolve them? Of course, you people. You people means you guys are going to be SAP consultant. You are the master. So you guys are going to solve these issues, right? So SAP consultant only. Now Tata Motor employees, they are not the expert of SAP. Simply, they are the users. It means they are going to use this SAP, right? Who is the expert? Consultants are the expert, the people who has installed this SAP, the people who has configured this SAP for Tata Motor, right? So they are the experts. SAP consultant are the experts. So now post implementations also, what is happening, guys? Tata Motor required support to proceed further. If Tata Motor got some additional requirement, right? Additional requirement means they are saying that we need some special kind of reports. So who is going to develop this report, guys? Of course, consultant. There will be involvement of consultant. Let's suppose some changes happen in the tax structure of a particular country, whether it is India, USA, UK, Australia, whichever countries are there. So now what is happening, guys? It means as per the new structure, now again some changes are required into SAP, right? Now let's suppose some changes happen in terms of depreciations percentage calculations. So again some changes. So this is a continuous process, guys. So now what will happen for that? Of course, support is required. Who is going to support, guys? Consultant. So now here in support activity, this is a continuous activity. If somebody, let's suppose Tata Motor has installed this SAP, then lifelong they need support from consultant, right? So in support project, what is happening? Look at here. Post implementations means after implementations, all SAP related, all SAP maintenance or error related activities are going to be part of support project itself. It means like and here I have specified here consultant just receive a ticket, solve them and send them back to the client. Say for example, IBM has implemented this SAP into Tata Motor. It means IBM has like they're having a team of consultant. They'll be having like if whichever IT company we are talking about, guys, they'll be having multiple such team, because if you talk about projects, every companies are having several projects, might be 100 project, 200 project, 300 projects. So multiple team will be there. Now what is happening? IBM is constructed a team for Tata Motor. So those team is dedicated, like they are dedicated to this Tata Motor project itself. They have done the implementations. After implementations, again Tata Motor says that I need support also. So again there will be further contract between Tata Motor and IBM, that okay. So for certain period of time, might be 4 years, 5 years, 10 years, whatever it is. So now what is happening, guys? So IBM, so there will be on behalf of IBM, in the sense like IBM is going to construct a team for this support also. A particular team will be there sitting at somewhere at central location in any particular metropolitan cities. Now, so Tata Motor, whenever Tata Motor is going to face any issues, so their employee, what will happen? They are going to take the screenshot. In a simplest way, I'm just explaining, guys. I'm not going to discuss about the ticketing tools here right now. But what will happen? Let's suppose Tata Motor employee is going to take the screenshot of that error and they are going to send a mail. To whom? To the consultant. Okay. So now, as a consultant, since you are a finance consultant, and if any error has been received by finance team, so they are going to take the screenshot and they will send it to you. So now the mail came to your inbox. You have opened your mailbox and you have seen like, okay, these are the requirements which you have received from Tata Motor. So one by one, you have to just have a look on those errors and all, and you have to rectify and you have to send it back to the client. So this is what it is called, like consultant just receive tickets, errors. Errors are whatever errors they are going to receive. Every errors, every requirement is going to be treated as a tickets. Sometimes what is happening, guys, I told you a very simplest way, like they will take the screenshot and they are going to send you a mail. Even sometime, like most of the time, not sometime, client will use some ticketing tool. Ticketing tool means what, guys? There'll be, it's a kind of like, let's suppose, software itself, you can say, right? So in that, like screen capture functionality will be there. They'll capture the screen and say, for example, they will attach it. They'll attach some requirements. They're going to attach some documents and all, and they are going to click on submit. Once they submit, automatically one auto-generated mail is going to be triggered to you, and you will get the notifications that the requirement has been raised by client, right? So whatever way is there, we are talking about support project. So under support project, what comes, guys? Under support project, all these errors or maintenance related activities, that is going to become under support project.